There are planes at Alexandria's Chandler Field Airport every day, but not like these. The Wings of Freedom Tour is in town to make World War II history come alive.
It's a hands-on flying air museum. We travel around the United States. Like I said, we do about 103 stops each year around the United States, and you can. It's a living exhibit. You go through the airplanes, you can touch the machine guns, you can see where the pilots and everybody sat, and get a perspective of what it was like. A lot of people can't believe how small it was inside. A lot of people can't believe how big it is on the outside.
Mac McCauley is a volunteer pilot for the tour. He says they travel around the country making more than 100 stops a year. With them are a B-24 Liberator and a B-17 Flying Fortress. And then there's the bomber's little friend, the P-51 Mustang. Among the many onlookers are a few remaining World War II veterans, including Elvin Andrews. He was a bombardier and navigator on a B-17. At 93, he still remembers that danger of flying over Europe.
When I get back on the ground, I'd go around and I'd count the flak holes in the plane because the flak was pretty close, and sometimes you could hear it when it hit the plane. And
today, Elvin met fellow veteran Wilbur Nelson of Evansville. Nelson is also 93, but despite his age, today he was able to get back inside the familiar place he'd spent 30 missions.
But they offered me a ride, and I says, no, 30's enough. I'm superstitious.
As Wilbur looked inside the B-17, the memories started coming back quickly.
Yeah, that's where I was. And then they had a gun bike up there. In case they had big trouble, they had to grab a gun.
As a lead radio operator, he spent most of his time in this part of the plane, right behind the bomb bay, with one little window to the outside world. Each one of his missions were journaled, from the first one in August of 1944 to the last one on February 3rd, 1945.
We were bombing Berlin, and when we landed at our airport, I got out and I kissed the ground, and the colonel said, "What are you doing, Captain?" I says, "I'm done. I'm going home."
When asked what it was like to be back in a B-17, Nelson says,
"Makes it a little creepy."
Is it?
Well, there's a lot of memories.
The memories of those 6 months aren't just in his head. The sub-zero temperatures at high altitudes left a lasting mark on his hands.
20 below.
So you're constantly dealing with cold hands. And
your hands get it. Because you can't hardly wear gloves if you're going to use that equipment.
The airport was filled with people appreciative of the sacrifice he had made.
You did a fantastic job.
Well, we thought we did. Yep.
Thank you for your service.
Thank you.
Well, you're treasures.
Oh, well.
Appreciate you all.
Hope my wife thinks so, too. We've been married 72 years.
And 72, congratulations.
And she's 92, yeah.
And you're 93.
Yep, she will be in September.
God is good.
Yeah, he had sat right alongside of me.
That's right.
With many close calls in his past and much thanks in his heart, Wilbur bids goodbye to his old friend for what may be the last time. But who knows? He stared death in the face many times before and come out just fine. For the Voice of Alexandria, I'm Joe Krakowski. Yeah.